7-8. All right, Mike ready, and so am I. Welcome back to the Tours 2 Off for Ice National Championships here in Taylor, Michigan, as we get set for the 16U AAA Championship, and it features the home team, the Tour Roadrunners, a perennial powerhouse at this age group, and they will face off against the Mission Sting. They will be the visitors in this game. Mission Sting wear the black jerseys. They'll go from left to right on your screen in period one. And the Tour Roadrunners will wear the white jerseys with green trim. And they'll go from right to left on your screen. How's everybody doing out there? Chris Treft with you here on STLSportsProductions.com, the exclusive home for live streaming of all games here at the Taylor Sportsplex in the 2015 Tours 2 Off for Ice National Championships. And we have a special featured matchup featuring play-by-play from yours truly. And picked a good one to do play-by-play on. This one is going to be an excellent matchup. You have two very talented and very speedy teams. To note, the Mission Sting only have six players on their roster, and you've got to believe that Anthony Violante, the head coach of the Tour Roadrunners, is going to try to run and gun as much as he can to try and wear these Sting players out. Come all the way from Georgia, Tour Roadrunners, all the way from New York, respectively. I thought George Brown was going to join me here, but he'll join me in a minute or two. So here we go. All set. Referees checking the goaltenders to see if they're ready. Victor Paluzzi and Kurt Ahmer, all your netminders, and the opening faceoff is won by the Roadrunners, and it's controlled by Faust in behind his own goal. He'll hit the brakes as the breakout will set up here for the Tour Roadrunners. Comes up to Max Halvorsen. He tries to fire it back in his own end. That one's blocked. Comes right back to him. So he will control and send it back for Romanowicz. Romanowicz back for Halvorsen in front of the player benches. He'll cruise down the right wing slowly. And then he'll get it taken away from him as it's controlled by Magera. Magera throws it off in the corner. He'll get the return feed as he crosses the red line. Splits through a couple of Roadrunner forecheckers. Skates the far circle. Wrist shot at Ahmer down to the butterfly. Making the easy save as we get a stoppage in play with 11:17 left in the first period. Kurt Ahmer, the native of the Pittsburgh area, playing for the Roadrunners, and Anthony Violante, which he usually tends to do. He plays at all levels. A big netminder, especially for his age. Covers a lot of net, and he has athleticism to back it up when his size can't stop the puck, which is sometimes a rarity. Such a good goaltender is Kurt Ahmer. Comes back through center, and Galicchio will give it back to Faust. Faust will spin back in his own zone, retreats with a pass to Halvorsen. Halvorsen will roll in behind his own goal, hit the brakes. 10:46 now left in the first period as he plays it back up to the near side. Faust will chip it around the forecheckers. He heads down the left wing. Faust to the backhand. Now to the forehand. He tries to cut in front, but Paluzzi gets a stick on it and pushes it over to the far corner. Galicchio gets away from two Sting defenders and plays it back for Faust. Faust will just roll one onto Halvorsen. And getting to that one is Magera as he fires it wide of the goal. The Sting with the better opportunity so far on the Roadrunners. As now Halvorsen looks to change that. He'll skate through the near circle, head fakes, throws it into the slot, and that one is deflected off of work for the Sting in front and goes wide. Romanowicz had a wide open net, but work a nice defensive position to block that one and keep this game scoreless. Faust behind his own goal again. Jake Corso off the bench. He'll skate over the puck and come out on the left side of the net, and he'll get the feed. As he comes down the near wall now, crosses the red line, saucer pass down low. This one will be controlled and brought in around the back of the net. It comes back to the point now. And O'Neal controls deep in his own zone. O'Neal just posted up behind his own net. The Sting being very passive on the forecheck, almost back in a box-like defense. When you have a talented team such as the Roadrunners, you have to be careful and not let their talent take over as it comes back to DeMartino. DeMartino will turn this one over on an attempted pass up to Corso. And the Sting finally have possession. Fecto will send it up into the slot for Magera. Magera will hit Ladinsky in stride. Drop it back for Fecto. Fecto back for Ladinsky. And he'll just saucer one back on the backhand all the way deep in his own zone, and Work will control. Work, number 22 for the Sting. We'll leave it aside, and it's controlled by Fecto. JJ Fecto moves up court. Doesn't like what he sees, so he'll backtrack as he rolls in behind his own goal and puts on the brakes. 8:23 now left in the first period. Sting and Roadrunners in the U16 AAA final. Work, long pass up to the red line for the control by Magera. Magera couldn't get around DeMartino, but the puck caroms back to him. He tries to split the defense, and nothing happening there as O'Neal and DeMartino put the body on Fecto, negating that opportunity. Excuse me, Magera, who had that opportunity. Now DeMartino, diagonal pass up to Corso at the red line. He cuts around Magera, slides into the slot. Now to the backhand, over to the back door, and that one hits off a skate and comes back to him as he controls in the near corner. He slides this one back to O'Neal. O'Neal feeds DeMartino in his own zone. DeMartino, who has a brother, plays in the pro division. PJ DeMartino will get it up to Corso. Corso to Halverson, bouncing around in front, a chance for the Roadrunners, but they couldn't put this one past Paluzzi as it goes over to the far wall now. O'Neal will pinch in and keep this puck in the zone, as looking to clear as Fecto. Couldn't muscle his way out of the zone, so he'll just fire it behind his own net. And it's controlled by Work for the Sting. 7:10 left in the first period, and that one is played back to Fecto now as he'll quarterback the breakout. He's got Galicchio in defensive position right on top of the goal crease. This Work tries to clear it, but that one hits off the back of the net. Now eventually it comes up and Work will control. He's watched by Romanowicz, and Romanowicz will take it away from him. Headman pass for Galicchio. He couldn't handle that one, and Work will try to take it away from him on the back check. Couldn't quite accomplish that as it's sent back into the Roadrunners zone for the carry-on by Max Halverson. Halverson up for Romanowicz. Romanowicz will feed Faust in stride as he comes in with speed. Skates over the far corner now with the puck as he sent one wide of the goal. And it's controlled by Fecto again. Fecto will lead Magera with the pass. Magera, nice move to the outside. Then a quick shot, it rings off the iron. Beautiful play from Magera. He beat everybody on the Roadrunners, but he couldn't beat the post as it rings iron. Crisis averted here for the Roadrunners, and they'll control now. Halverson, nice head fake as he breaks free into the Sting zone. Now it comes back for Romanowicz as he walks into the near side circle and fires one into the glove of Paluzzi, who covers things up and stops play with 5:51 left in the first period. And the faceoff will be in the near side circle, deep in the Sting zone. Jordan Mueller in on a draw against Bremington. And that faceoff is won by Mueller, and the Roadrunners control. Hard forecheck put on by Ladinsky, but DeMartino breaks free from him. He comes in with a toe drag and a quick shot, and it's bounced around in the crease. Where's it at? It's in the net. Unbelievable play by Joey DeMartino. He breaks away from Ladinsky on the back check, comes into the top of the near circle, beautiful toe drag, and then fires a quick shot that Paluzzi got a piece of, but I don't think he saw it as it popped up into the air. Then it landed right between his feet. I'm not sure if it just trickled in or Mueller got a piece of it. But nonetheless, the Roadrunners have the early lead with 5:27 left in the first period. They're going to look for more here as it's bumped up to O'Neal at the red line. He turns and looks towards goal. And the right-handed number 17 for the Roadrunners plays it up for Jake Corso. Corso retreats in his own end to the top of the circles on a pass for Joey DiMartino. Now DiMartino will go back to Corso far side. Corso to the outside, back to the middle. O'Neill, wrist shot, score, Roadrunners! Just like that, in under 30 seconds, the Roadrunners have a 2-0 lead on an already shorthanded Sting roster. When you got kids like Galicchio, Corso, Joey DiMartino, who are under the age of 15 and 16, and they've already had a cup of coffee in the pro division, they play against older opponents all the time, they win multiple age groups, it's just so tough to get a beat on these guys and stop the offensive attack. As Corso nearly made it three, as he rings it off the iron and a shot from the far circle. Magueras gonna look to get something going for the Sting. The black jersey, left-handed number 19 for the Sting, will bring it in through the slot. And he's checked off the puck by DiMartino, and a penalty coming against the Sting. Must have been a high stick or something of that facet. As back to the way comes O'Neill, he plays it through the slot. It's touched up by the Sting, and a power play coming to the Roadrunners, and it's going to be a slash. Magueras doesn't like the call at all. He's going to head to the penalty box. 1:30 up on the board, and the rich look to get richer. The Roadrunners already have a 2-0 lead, and they're going to look to make it four here with the main advantage. Over to DiMartino, top of the circle, far side. He'll go back center point to Halverson, back to DiMartino. Those two continue to play catch. DiMartino looks towards goal, and he'll play it down to the goal line for Galicchio. Back to the hash marks for DiMartino, far side. Left point now for Halverson. Halverson looks back door for Galicchio, doesn't make the pass. Drops into the faceoff dot for Corso. His shot is stopped by Paluzzi, and it comes back to the near side, and Halverson picks it up and controls. He'll go to the right point for DiMartino. He'll walk into the faceoff dot, down low for Galicchio. Galicchio back in the slot. Martino score! Roadrunners! I could hardly keep up with it. There's a beautiful passing there from the Roadrunners. Tic-tac-toe. Into the net she goes. And it's now 3-0 in favor of the Roadrunners. If you're this team, you have got to find a way to not take penalties. As you saw there, how deadly that power play could be. Beautiful passing. Great finish by DiMartino. And a 3-0 score in favor of the two Roadrunners out of Long Island, New York. Faust controls, and he'll fire it back for Max Halverson. Halverson just waiting patiently in his own end for a Sting forecheck. They're down by three. They got to put some sort of pressure on the Roadrunners, or they're just going to sit back and kill the clock in this game. The Sting's whole game plan is to get a lead and then play this sit-back defense with having the small numbers they do, but they trail by three now, and they're going to have to get a little more aggressive here on the forecheck. Brewington is the only man up court for the Sting, and now the Roadrunners advance. They'll just go back in their own zone. No sense of urgency here for the Roadrunners, as they don't really need it. Already up 3-0 here in the later stages of period one. Romanowicz brings it into the zone finally for the Roadrunners. He cuts to the middle now. He'll just fire it back for Halverson. Brewington finally puts a little bit of pressure on, and Halverson will play it to Romanowicz. And Romanowicz will go back. He skates over the puck, and the Sting come away with possession, so patience pays off for the Mission Sting. As they now control, Fecto tries to get around Romanowicz. Romanowicz picks his pocket, leads a 2-on-1, throws it to the back door. And that one just misses. As the Roadrunners regain possession on the rebound, and it's Halverson with control of it. Halverson, the native of New Jersey, will just wait for his line change to be completed. His three combatants will head off, and Corso, DiMartino, and Galicchio onto the floor. His reinforcements played up to DeMartino. He goes cross, ring for Corso near side. Back to the far side for DeMartino. From the faceoff dot to the slot for Corso. He gets a shot off. It's pinballing around. Still whacking at it, and it goes in. Persistence pays off for the Roadrunners. They get four whacks at it. Paluzzi makes the first three saves, and the fourth one finally goes in. .11 left in the first period and a commanding, if three wasn't enough, 4-0 lead for the Roadrunners. DeMartino, pass up ahead to Faust. Wing to wing for Corso, who has it in front of the player benches. Over to Galicchio. Galicchio, a shot and a glove save from Paluzzi, who deflects it up into the netting, which draws the whistle with 53.2 seconds left in the first. And the faceoff will be to the right of Paluzzi. Left circle, Brewington against Mueller on the draw, and Mueller, as he's done all game, wins it clean. Comes back for Faust. As Faust will move up the gut of the rink. As the Roadrunners looking to attack again. A hooking call coming against Ledinsky. The Roadrunners are going to pull Almer. They'll go back for Faust. 20 seconds left. One more chance for the Roadrunners if they hurry here. 13 seconds remaining, and Halverson takes his time entering the zone as now he crosses the red line slowly. Down to the hash marks, far side for Galicchio. Galicchio, right point for Halverson. Halverson, now left side faceoff circle for Faust. Shot at the horn. A save made by Paluzzi. And after one period of play, the Roadrunners all over the Mission Sting by a score of 4-0. I'll take a quick audio break, and we'll be back for the second period here on your exclusive home for the 2015 Tours Too Hot for Ice National Championships in Taylor, Michigan, STLSportsProductions.com. I'll be back. And welcome back to the Tours 2 Off Ice National Championships here in Taylor, Michigan on STLSportsProductions.com. I have a special guest here in the booth now. I'm joined by Tours 2 Off Ice Principal, Joe Bernicini. Joe, how you doing?
Doing well, Chris. How you doing?
I'm doing fantastic. Just enjoying this U16 AAA Championship game between the Roadrunners and Sting, as the Tour Roadrunners, up by four, look to make it five as they have the man advantage. And if it goes anything like their last power play, this may be a quick one. A lot of talent on the floor here for the Roadrunners.
Absolutely.
Puck comes down to the hash marks, back up for Halverson. As they'll work the right side, roll the Roadrunners, comes back to the center point, still continuing to work the near wall. Now go behind, a nice try there for DeMartino. Trying a nice little elusive, leave the puck behind the net and switch players. Didn't quite work out, but they still control here. Halverson, quick shot, and a score for the Roadrunners. And that's just poetry in motion out there, Joe.
Max Halverson, some player. He got his first taste of the pro division this year, and he is some kind of player. Very impressive kid.
I mean, he's under the age of 16. He's already had a cup of coffee in the pro division. He plays D1, junior, double A, all the highest levels, and it only can make a kid like him even better every time he plays at these higher levels.
Yes, sir.
As a 5-0 lead here for the Roadrunners as the faceoff comes back to center. And Joe, let's talk about the event so far. I mean, how's it gone in your eyes?
Yeah, it's been absolutely great. I think outside of yesterday, we got a little bit behind, but we've had little to no issues all week. And hockey's been great. A lot of great games, some upsets, and all divisions. It's been a fantastic event.
I mean, if you know, every tournament could go this cleanly as it's gone so far, I mean, that would just make everybody's lives that much easier and that much more fun. And not only has the tournament gone relatively smoothly, but the hockey has just been tremendous.
We've gotten a lot of good comments, a lot of people having a great time, and you know, that's our main focus, to make sure everyone here has a good time at the event. And a lot of hard work goes into it, and it's good to see all the kids and families having a great time.
Yeah, if the players and parents only knew all the hard work that you and myself and the Tourist Too Hot for Ice staff does before the tournament even starts, I think they might have a whole new respect for the tournament, as we have a penalty coming against the Sting as Ledinsky laid the body on one of the Roadrunner players behind the net. And you know, the Roadrunners might just be content with killing this clock.
Absolutely. You know, the Sting look a little tired here. They're playing a couple divisions, but you know, this is some kind of team. I think they've turned a lot of heads this year, getting to this game, beating a big-time powerhouse in the Border Cats. They will be a force next year.
And they do it all with 6 players.
Yes, and Brewington is a little bit under the weather, so you know, they're almost down to 5.5, but you know, they got some big-time players in this team. Austin McGuire got a full ride to Sacred Heart. Of course, JJ Fecto. I've seen these kids since they were 8 years old. They have nothing to be ashamed of here.
And that's the thing, when these guys play together for so long that they just build this chemistry. And it's like, for you, a guy who's been around the game for so long and been to so many tournaments and put together so many tournaments, you're almost seeing these kids grow up before your eyes.
Absolutely. Both of these teams, the Roadrunners, I mean, look at guys like Joey DiMartino and Nick Delamorte, and you know, I've seen these kids since they were little. It's fun to watch.
As a power play has commenced here for the Roadrunners, already up by 5. They're 2-for-2 on the main advantage with 2 beautiful passing plays. They're going to send out the second unit and see what they can work out. This one comes back to the point for O'Neill. O'Neill over to Faust, top of the circle, on the near wall. He'll go down low to Mula. Or excuse me, Romanowicz. Mula's on the far side as Romanowicz comes out to the right point. And he'll go back to the center point now for Faust. Faust over the top of the circle, far side for O'Neill. O'Neill will roll back a little bit, now pop back to the top of the circle, fires in front, looking for a deflection from Mula, and it's stopped by Paluzzi, and Work controls, so play it back for Fecto. Fecto tries to go back to Work, but a nice forecheck by Mula. He'll intercept that one and send it back into his own zone, so they keep possession here. 8:41 left in the second, 32 seconds left in the man advantage. Back to Faust again. He'll go to the near circle for Romanowicz. Romanowicz, skates back to the right point, goes over to the left point for Faust. Faust waits and then fires, and a save by Paluzzi. And we get a stoppage here with 8:23 left in the second period. 15 seconds remaining in the power play. You know, Joe, we're only halfway through the tournament, and you know, what are your expectations for the last 4 days?
Well, we're going to have another couple busy days here today and tomorrow. Then we got the adults, the women's, and the old man division starting up this weekend. So looking forward to a good holiday weekend for sure.
Are you lacing up the skates again this year?
Yeah, unfortunately, that won't be a pretty sight. But looks like I have no choice.
You're being forced into it. There's 2 seconds now, 1, and a nice penalty kill by the Sting. We'll see if they can get some momentum off of this. As Delamorte fires a shot in on goal. It goes wide. And it's played back over to the far corner for Ledinsky. He'll just send it in behind the goal. And it's controlled by Fecto. Fecto curls back behind his own goal line. Now he'll be in the near corner as he rolls slowly over to that area. He's got Galicchio hard on the forecheck. And, you know, Galicchio is another one of those kids that's just getting a ton of experience playing in multiple divisions. And he's a little guy, but definitely can't tell with how much heart he has out there.
And he's a fast player, for sure.
One of the fastest skaters you'll see, especially at his own age group.
It's one thing both of these teams have in common. They have a lot of team speed.
Speaking of speed, here comes DeMartino, mixing the speed with a little bit of flair with the hands as he goes to the outside and fires one wide. Now it bounced back through neutral court, and looks like Magero is going to have a break, but it just rolls away from him. A little bit of bad puck luck as Delamorte back the other way to the backhand. Now forehand score, Roadrunners! Oh my goodness, what a beautiful play there, and the Roadrunners now have a 6-0 lead.
They're making things look real easy out here, and it's fun to watch.
I mean, 2 goals away from the mercy rule to be put in effect, and when you do that in a championship game, it only leads and shows the domination at this age group that the Roadrunners have.
Yeah, there's no doubt, but you know, these two teams have played a lot against each other here at national tournaments, and there isn't a 6-goal differential here. This is I think an abnormality here in this one.
And like you said, there's some factors leading to this 6-0 lead against the Sting. Like you said, Brewington not feeling the greatest, a little bit under the weather, which is always unfortunate when the bug hits you, you know, at the one time a year when you come to nationals. But they only have 6 players. They play in multiple divisions, and this just might be a situation where they're gassed and they're playing against a Roadrunners team who these guys are playing just as much, but they have 5 guys over on the bench waiting.
And no doubt, and the Sting has had some tough hard matchups. I think the Roadrunners look like the fresher team. Oh, there we go. There's Magera with a goal.
Just when we're talking about how they don't have any energy left, Magera proves us wrong. A nice power move to the outside as he moves down the left wing and cuts back to the middle and puts it to the 5-hole Almer, and it's now a 5-goal advantage for the Roadrunners.
You know, with Austin Magera, not too many people know about him when it comes to this thing. Everyone wants to talk about JJ Fecto, but Austin Magera is some kind of player. Like I said, he's got a full ride to Sacred Heart to play ice hockey, and we wish him the best.
He's not even 18 yet, so excellent player in his own right, roller and ice, as JJ Fecto will play it up to him. Fecto on ice pass to Spring Magera. Magera tries to go between his own legs. Look like he's gained a little bit of confidence here in this game. That confidence not working there, as Delamorte over for Mula, and his shot goes off the shoulder of Paluzzi. And the rebound controlled by Fecto. Fecto will lead the rush for the Sting. Elevates one over to Magera on the near wall. He comes in against Corso. Gets around him, over to Ledinsky, and his shot is blocked. And now Mula plays it back for Fecto. Fecto finds Ledinsky. Ledinsky with a shot, and that one will go wide of the goal. And it's controlled once again by the Sting, as Malley has the puck roll up on him, and Galicchio is going to have a breakaway. Cuts to the backhand, score, Roadrunners! We talked about the speed earlier, and he showed it off. A great stretch up the floor and a nice move on the backhand, and it's back to a 6-goal advantage for the Roadrunners. Just an unfortuitous play.
Yeah, it looks like Sting. There's been several of those this game. You know, started with the first goal of the game with that puck bouncing high up into the air, kind of just bouncing into the net. Roadrunners are catching a lot of breaks here, but you know, they are a phenomenal team.
You know, sometimes the best teams have so much luck because they have so many talented players, and talented players just seem to have the puck almost come to them like a magnet at times.
You make your own breaks here.
As a shot comes in on Almer, he makes a nice easy glove save. And I talked about Almer early on the broadcast, but I mean, he's a great goalie with a lot of size and a lot of upside and a bright future.
Absolutely. He's a big kid, takes up a lot of the net, and kind of fits the mold of this Roadrunner team.
And at times he doesn't rely on his size to make a save. He does have excellent athleticism, even for being a big kid, to recover and make some saves when he gets caught out of position, which is a rarity. As Corso will send it around the perimeter over to the far corner. Delamorte will play right back for him. No one bounces away from him. It'll be controlled by Galicchio. He'll turn it over, and the carry-on now by Work. Work's got Fecto going to the net. He'll just take the shot, and that one is blocked, and Corso controls. Corso cutting around the forechecking Fecto. You know, he plays it up court, hits off a skate. Lucky break there, comes right back to him. He'll go back to Galicchio and head off for a change. Roadrunner's looking for a stretch pass for Mueller, and that one is blocked. And then a whistle blows. It might be too many men call. But if it was...
I think that's what they got, Chris.
Yeah, but the Sting had the puck. Kind of negated a break there for him. But no argument for the Roadrunners. They know what they did. Lazy, got a little bit lazy on the change. And a too many men is called. And a power play here for the Sting. Off the faceoff, it's won by Halvorsen. Halvorsen back over to the far side. O'Neill in a battle with Brewington. Coming in to help out was Faust, and he'll pop it free back up for O'Neill. O'Neill gets knocked down by Brewington, and Brewington, nice job to come away with the puck. Up for Fecto now. Fecto slowly rolls down the near wall. He'll slide to the middle. Walk into the slot. His wrist shot is blocked, and it goes over into the far corner. As Brewington, he's got O'Neill all over him. Comes back for Work. Quick shot by Work. He's bouncing around. Ends up over on the near side hash marks, and it's chipped down into the corner by Work as Brewington on the forecheck. Couldn't get away from Faust. Faust bumps it up to Halvorsen. Halvorsen speeding down the far wall, puts on the brake. So does Work. Nice job defensively to get back. But Halvorsen cuts back to the inside now, gets a shot away that's stopped by Paluzzi. And it's cleared out of the dangerous scoring area by Work.
Victor Paluzzi, he's played well in response. Not the normal goalie here for the Sting, so he's filled in well for him. Tough game today, but tournament-wide, he's played pretty well.
Faust tries to slide to the middle, and that one hits off a skate and comes to Brewington. Brewington, long stretch pass up for Magara. Magara, nice move to the inside. Cuts the backhand, but he could not get a shot away. And another penalty coming against the Roadrunners. So the Sting will stay on the power play as they trail by six here. And, you know, as Joe looks to step out here, he's going to go down and set up the award ceremony. So any last words here?
No, Chris, just thanks to all the teams, players, and all the people out there watching. Thanks for being part of this event.
Well, thanks to Joe for stepping in here, giving us some good insight and a different perspective here on the broadcast as the Sting look to make this score a little bit more respectable. There's a solid chance they're probably not going to come back in this game, but maybe get a couple goals here late and make it look like a closer game than it really was. There's a high shot put over the net by Magara. And it comes back to the near side for Brewington. Brewington back to the point. Fecto couldn't control. He'll go back to pick it up. And Fecto will roll through the far circle. He'll drop it off to Magara. Magara down low. He tries to give and go, but that one's blocked. And now Fecto tries the nice toe drag, but it's taken away from him by Delamorte, and he'll control here with a minute 23 left in the game. And 40 seconds remaining in the power play. Corso back over the near side for Delamorte. He'll spin away from a check and then fall down. He's got Magara still badgering him. And finally, DiMartino gets rid of it over to Corso. Corso puts on the brakes behind his cage. Pass out to the left wing for Delamorte. Delamorte slides, long pass up ahead for DiMartino. Walks in against Fecto. He pivots to protect the puck against number 10, JJ Fecto. That one slides away from DiMartino, and he gets back to it and just chips it down into the corner. Now back up for DiMartino. On back for Delamorte. Over for Faust. Oh, I got you. Faust now back for DiMartino. DiMartino fires one up ahead, intercepted by Fecto. Fecto walks into the slot, big slap shot. That one's blocked by DiMartino. Goes over to the far corner for Faust. Back to even strength go the Roadrunners. 15 seconds left in this game. And that'll just about do it. The Fat Lady's getting ready to sing here has only 5 seconds left, and the horn will sound. The Tua Roadrunners are the 2015 16U AAA champions with a decisive 7-1 victory over the Mission Sting out of Georgia. So congratulations to both teams, the Sting on their silver medal, and the Roadrunners on getting their gold, the big cup, and the championship banner. So now I'm going to turn things back over to George Brown for the announcement of the gold and silver medalists, your individual award winners, and the presentation of the Tour's Too Hot for Ice National Championship Cup and banner. All right, George, take it away.
Thank you very much, Trusty. I'm going to have them plug me in downstairs so we can get this award ceremony underway. We are completed with the Bantam AAA Championship game, and our champions here are the Tour Roadrunners. So we are set to go with our award ceremony here in Bantam AAA. We'll start off by awarding our runner-up, the Mission Sting 98 team. Receiving their medals, number 19, Austin McGuire. Number 22, Austin Work. Number 72, Braden Brewington. Number 71, Jason Ledzinski. Number 10, JJ Fechtel. Number 5, Sam Molly. And goaltender number 35, Victor Paluzzi. At this time, Tours Too Hot for Ice would like to present the second place plaque to your runner-up in the Bantam AAA division, head coach Jerry Fechtel and Mission Sting 98. And now for your champions in Bantam AAA, the Tour Roadrunners. Number 3, Jake Corso. Number 14, Max Romanowicz. Number 13, number 9, Anthony Galicio. My bad, wrong number, sorry. Number 68, Max Halverson. Number 18, Joey DiMartino.
Hello. Hold on 1 second.
Number 4, Nick Delamorte.
Where are you at?
Number 17, Connor O'Neill. Number 48, Zach Faust. Number 88, Jordan Mueller. And goaltender number 33, Kurt Almer. And now for your Bantam AAA individual award winners. We will start off with your high score. High score is based on total points throughout round robin play only. Your high score in Bantam AAA goes to, from the Detroit Border Cats, Kalen Kafuk. Is Kalen here? I know he's in the building. We will make sure he gets his award. We will move on to your top dishman. Dishman is based on total assists throughout round robin play. Your top dishman in the Bantam AAA division goes to, from the Mission Sting 98, number 19, Austin McGuire. And your top goaltender, based on save percentage throughout round robin play, goes to, from the Tour Roadrunners, number 33, Kurt Almer. There's Kalen. One more round of applause for Kalen Kafuk, our high score in Bantam AAA. And now, Tours to Out for Ice would like to present the Championship Cup and Championship Banner to your champions in Bantam AAA, the Tour Roadrunners.
What up? You called earlier.